El Salvador has paved the way. And who are they teaming up with? What's going on? What's an embassy in the United States?
Yeah, it's a they're teaming up with tech with a Texas with the Texas government to create a Bitcoin embassy, and to, in order to kind of spread the to help fund and develop and organize Bitcoin adoption in Texas, and to potentially, I guess, to collaborate on some maybe some legislation. I know Texas has been positioning itself as sort of a hub for crypto, specifically Bitcoin mining. And there's even talk in this article, and it's nothing concrete, but there's a little mention that there could be some legislation passed which would make crypto purchases in Texas tax-free. I guess you would be saving that sales tax, that 8%. So that could be very cool. That would be another example of incentivizing people to start bringing in foreign investment, even outside, whether outside the United States or globally, but at least even inside the United States, to have to bring your crypto to Texas, and you get to have an 8% premium in whatever you purchase, that or a discount rather. That's significant.
Well, hey, if you're a Texas lawmaker and you're looking to pass crypto-friendly laws, and you'd like some information or some knowledge about what's going on in the blockchain crypto markets, feel free to reach out to us, and we'll be happy to help you in any way that we can. We are pro crypto-friendly laws and regulations, and we happen to be in Texas, and this hits close to home. So this article is great. I love seeing Texas pioneer and pave the way. Like you said, they've actually also, when it comes to alternative energy, have been one of the leaders in that when it comes to production in the nation.
Yeah.
And we know that Bitcoin and blockchain crypto, many are actually resorting to alternative energy sources as their, I think the study came out saying Bitcoin is over 50% mined by green energy, or is wow. not so, but.
Well, now that a lot of mining has moved to Texas, and Texas has a big wind farm industry, I could see how that could happen. Yeah.
Was it El Salvador that was using a volcano, or was it Guatemala? Yes. I mean, this.
Yeah.
Many ways to mine Bitcoin, but so this is really neat. And again, it's ways that blockchain and crypto can help stimulate local economies in times of recessions or downturns. There are pockets of trapped wealth in the digital asset blockchain world. And it's really neat to see El Salvador take this model and help spread it to other parts of the world. That's just really beautiful. I think it's really great what El Salvador is doing, and that they're doing this with Texas. It'd be great to see how this kind of ripples out in other areas that become crypto-friendly embassies. And it's great because this is where learning, education will take place. You know, the local vendors, the merchants, the people that live around there. How's this working out, or what's going on here? Then all of a sudden they get a Web 3.0 wallet and start mining or start staking or start getting involved. So this is how the learning kind of spreads and the adoption spreads. If you like this information and you would like to learn about what's going on in the economy, the macro outlook, and how it applies to blockchain and the opportunities, you like this channel, hit the subscribe button, notification, hit the like button. That helps this knowledge get out. And of course, we will leave links below. You can support the channel below. And of course, if you like one-on-one help and you're saying, God, I would like to learn more about proof of work, proof of stake, layer ones, layer twos, what airdrops, IBC, interoperability, how does this stuff work? A Web 3.0 wallet, storage, security. That's right. We can help you out. Just fill out this information, your name, your email, what you'd like to learn about, and drop us a little message, and we'll be happy to get back to you and set up a time for some one-on-one consulting or some group tutorial sessions if you are with a firm or institution that is looking to catch your people up to speed. That's what we do, catch you up to speed. And I think that we've caught you up to speed on what's going on in the world today, right now. Have a beautiful day. Namaste. Until the next time. Thank you.